In this video lecture, we are going to see practice paper 1, March-April 2021, third language English. In this, we will see part A. Part B was already uploaded on our channel. Part B was for 1.5 hours and also part A is for 1.5 hours. So first, question number 1 to 5, read the following passage given carefully. As he reached Kadam's house, he saw Bhujaba coming towards him. Bhujaba was a known rascal of his village. Bayaji balanced the burden on his head. Straightening his neck, he said, "Greetings to you, sir. How are things with you?" Now, if we see here, there are two names coming. One is Bhujaba of a person and Bayaji. These are two persons. Don't get confused. Both are starting with the letter B. And the house name is Kadam. Now, let us understand this. Who was Bhujaba? Bhujaba was a rascal of the village. And Bayaji was a person. If we read this, Bayaji was Meher by caste, and according to age-old custom, he should have greeted Bhujaba with, "My humble salutations to you, sir, who are my father and mother." In this we can see that when Bhujaba came to Bayaji, Bayaji balanced the burden on his head and he said, "Greetings to you, sir. How are things with you?" Like, after just saying greetings, he has asked, "How are things with you?" in an informal manner. But we see here, Bayaji was a Meher by caste, that is lower caste. Bayaji belonged to a lower caste, and according to age-old custom, he should have greeted Bhujaba with, "My humble salutations to you, sir, who are my father and mother." That is, Bayaji should have greeted Bhujaba in a more respectful manner with these greetings. Here it is telling like that. Bayaji is of lower caste and he is going to greet Bhujaba. But instead of greeting in a very old age custom, he had greeted him informally, normally. So when Bayaji merely said greetings, Bhujaba became furious, that is, he became angry. And he said, who said? Bhujaba to Bayaji, "Do you think you can become a Brahmin merely by saying greetings?" Like, he just said greetings, he did not say, "You are like my father and mother." So can you forget your position simply because you have turned a Buddhist? So by this passage, we come to know that Bayaji had now become a Buddhist, but earlier he was Meher. Bayaji was nonplussed. Now, nonplussed means so confused and surprised that a person is unable to know how to react. Okay, and nonplussed is an adjective. So when he said like this, these words, Bayaji had that emotion. For a moment, he was tempted to knock him down. So Bayaji, who was of lower caste, wanted to knock down Bhujaba, but he couldn't afford to do so. Why didn't he knock him down when he said like that? Because now he had come back to his village for good. That is, he came back forever and he was to spend the rest of his days on this soil and would be interred in the same soil. Interred is a past participle of the word enter, and it is a verb. Enter means laying down a dead body in the ground. So Bayaji did not respond or did not knock Bhujaba down because he knew that he had to be buried in the same soil because he came back to the village and he would not be able to return to Pune or Bombay afterwards. It was not a good policy to incur the hostility of anyone in the village, least of the Patil, the village headman. Now let us see the questions. The first question is, how did Bayaji greet Bhujaba? What made Bhujaba furious? So there are two parts to this question. How did Bayaji greet Bhujaba? We know Bayaji greeted Bhujaba with humility and respect. Next is asking, why was Bhujaba furious? So Bhujaba was furious because Bayaji did not greet him in an age-old custom. That is, he did not greet him according to his way properly. Second question, can you forget your position simply because you have turned a Buddhist? Whose position the speaker is talking about? What was his position? In this passage, the speaker is talking about whose position and what was his position. So the answer is, the speaker is talking about Bayaji's position. Bayaji's position belonged to the lower strata of the society. Third question, why could Bayaji not return to Pune or Bombay? We see in the passage that Bayaji could not return to Bombay or Pune because he had retired from his service, that he had come forever to his village. Fourth question, what kind of person was Bhujaba, the village headman? Bhujaba, the village headman, was a greedy, proud and selfish person. We see here, right? because by the passage only we can understand. He was proud, he wanted others to greet him in a very age-old custom, greetings. Then he was selfish and he was also greedy. Fifth question, though Bayaji was tempted to knock Bujaba down, he controlled himself. Because he didn't want to get into trouble in the village. Because he belonged to the same village, he did not want to get into trouble. Question number 6 to 10. Read the following passage carefully. As a young cartoonist, Walt Disney faced many rejections from newspaper editors who said he had no talent. One day, a minister at a church hired him to draw some cartoons. Disney was working out of a small mouse-infested shed near the church. After seeing small mouse, he was inspired. That was the start of Mickey Mouse. Successful people don't do great things. They only do small things in a great way. One day, a partially deaf 4-year-old kid came home with a note in his pocket from his teacher. "Your Tommy is too stupid to learn. Get him out of the school." His mother read the note and answered, "My Tommy is not stupid to learn. I will teach him myself." And that Tommy grew up to become great Thomas Edison. Thomas Edison had only 3 months of formal schooling and he was partially deaf. Henry Ford forgot to put the reverse gear in the first car he made. So three personalities are mentioned in this passage. One is Walt Disney. Earlier he also had failure and then he became successful. And then it is talking about Thomas Edison. And then it is talking about Henry Ford. All of them had failures, but all of them became great personalities. So the question 6 is, how did the cartoon of Mickey Mouse came into limelight? Mickey Mouse came into limelight after Walt Disney faced many rejections. Later, he was inspired by a small mouse near a church. When he was inspired by a small mouse near a church, he made Mickey Mouse. So that was his, how he came into limelight. Next question, who is Tommy? What was his mother's reaction to the teacher's note? Here we can see Tommy is Thomas Edison and we know her reaction was, "My Tommy is not stupid to learn and she will teach herself." Answer is, Tommy was Thomas Edison. Her mother's reaction to the teacher's note was positive. She decided to teach her son. Eighth question, successful people don't do great things. They only do small things in a great way. Explain. This line means that people who are successful don't do great things. They achieve success by hard work, continual failures and perseverance. We can see all these three things were there in the personalities of Thomas Edison, Walt Disney and Henry Ford. What did it? They recently did hard work, continual failures and perseverance. Ninth question. Do you think that formal education alone is responsible to bring success in one's life? Justify. Formal education is not responsible for success. Formal education means the education which is given initially during earlier schools is called schooling is called as something but formal education. So only formal education will not be responsible for success. We all know that we all go to school, but not all are successful. So the life of Thomas Edison proves that one can become successful even without formal education. He only got 3 years of formal education and then his mom taught him and that too at home and then he had become partially deaf. So we know that formal education is not only responsible for success. 10th question, what was the setback of Henry Ford when he made his first car? We can see here, the setback of Henry Ford that was, he forgot to put the reverse gear in the first car he made. This is my answer, 10. Setback means the thing which is a mistake, but that is a learning point. That is called a setback or a failure. Question number 11. Write the choreography script for the given poem. This morning, she brought green methi in the market, choosing the freshest bunch, picked up a white radish, imagined the crunch it would make between her teeth, the sweet, sharp taste, then put it aside, thinking it an extravagance. Counted her coins out carefully, tied them a small bundle into her sari at the waist, came home, faced her mother-in-law's dark looks, took the leaves and chopped them, her hand stained yellow from the juice, cut an onion fine and cooked, the whole thing in the pot over the stove, shielding her face from the heat. Now in this choreographed script, you have to include the following ideas. You have to have title, you have to have theme or themes of the poem, instances of the theme, location, characters involved, and sequence of action. So let us write a choreography for the poem which is mentioned here. I hope you have understood. It is about a woman who goes to a market and who also has a mother-in-law. We have to write a choreography for it. Remember, the format will be, first you should have a title. So what is the title? You can say every woman faces that, so title can be another woman. Then who is the poet here? The poet is Imtiyan Dharkar. So write the poet's name. Then write the theme. What is the theme? It talks about dowry, it talks about human relationships, it talks about sex discrimination, and it talks about female feticide. All these are talked here if you read the poem. And then you have to write instance of the theme. What is the instance of theme? Mother-in-law is not treating her daughter-in-law well. The relationship between husband and wife is not respectful. And society is not taking care of women. These three are seen because the woman goes and cooks and she is getting heated up in the kitchen. Right? Location. Where is it? It is in marketplace and also in home. She goes to market and then she comes back again to home. So always in a choreography, you should have title, poet, theme, instance, location, then characters. What are the characters here? Daughter-in-law, mother-in-law, husband, and vegetable vendors. Then the sequence of action. Here we can see there are three scenes. Always, you should separate it in the form of three scenes. What is the scene one? Marketplace. Because in the first paragraph, we can say the woman is in market. Woman buying vegetables from the market, counting her money as she cannot afford expensive vegetables. Scene two, she's in kitchen. Woman cooking food, woman hearing mother-in-law using foul language and cursing her. That is what usually mother-in-laws do. Scene 3. Living room. Husband entering home. Husband and mother-in-law planning to burn the woman. Scene 4. Woman being burned to death. Then, after she dies, the curtain falls. These are the four scenes. And you should write again, what does the narrator want to say from that poem? So the narrator wants to say, social evil like dowry can be controlled by educating women, making them financially independent, and educating society. So how did you write the choreography? Choreography is written for a poem. You should have a title, you should have a poet, you should have a theme, you should have an instance of the theme, location, character, sequence of action, scene 1, scene 2, scene 3, scene 4, and the narrator's point of view. In options of 11th question you have, you might have understood the importance of forestation. Many things happen due to deforestation, such as changes in the rainfall pattern, inappropriate weather conditions, melting glaciers, global warming, etc. Now write a letter to the editor of a local newspaper to create awareness among the public on the importance of reforestation. You have to write a letter to the editor. You may include the following ideas: reasons for deforestation, effects of deforestation, need for reforestation, and social responsibility of individuals. We had seen format of formal letter in Social Studies Practice Paper 1 of Telangana, that is TS Practice Paper 1 Government of Social. But still, I'll again, in a brief way, explain you the format of formal letter. Here, always in a formal letter, whether it is a letter to editor or a complaint letter or any letter, you should have the sender's address, then date, then address to the editor, Deccan Chronicle, Secunderabad. That is, here you have the receiver's address. And then you have Sir, Respected Sir, that is salutation. And then always in a formal letter, you have the subject. The subject here is importance of reforestation or restoring reforestation. So how will I start? Since it is a letter to editor, I will start. I wish to express my views through your esteemed newspaper. Anthropogenic activities and pollution have led to deforestation. This in turn has led to less rainfall, inappropriate weather conditions, global warming, melting of glaciers, extinction of animals, soil erosion, depletion of water table, etc. In order to have ecological balance, reforestation is essential. I think you have noticed that I am changing paragraphs. Hence, it is the responsibility of every citizen to be aware of these problems and take measures for sustainable development. I request the authorities to look into planting more and more trees and take necessary action in this regard. Thanking you, yours truly. Then sign is written by XXX and name Shafin. This is my formal letter or letter to editor. Okay, you don't have to write each sentence in a new line. Okay, I've noticed most of you write each sentence in a new line, but that is absolutely wrong. Okay, you just have to write in paragraphs. Okay, don't write in sentences in letter. Question number 12. In the lesson, I will do it. You learned that Murthy was upset. as he could not join IIT due to their poor financial status. Later, as he went to station to say goodbye to his friends, he found them all excited. Though he qualified the exam, he stood silently and was not a part of their excitement. Imagine you are Murthy and make a diary entry describing your mixed feelings. So the format of diary entry is very simple. Most of us have a confusion whether diary entry will be in a box. No, diary entry should not be in a box. Okay, it can be on a paper. Simple. In diary entry, you have day, you have date, you have time. You may or you may not write dear diary since already it's your diary. Okay, and always remember, in diary, you should write in an informal way. How you talk to your friend, like that, you should be with your diary. So, I'm expressing all my emotions in a diary. I'm very upset today as I could not join IIT despite getting a good rank. Dad cannot afford this much fees. My friends have all left to start their new life. I have compromised on this fact. I realized that an institute does not determine your success. It is our hard work and dedication that brings sunshine in our life. Hence, I have resolved to pursue my dream from my hometown by working harder. On the last, you should have your name. So here my name is Murthy and I have written my name at the last, Murthy. Okay, this is how you write a diary entry. Remember, day, date, time, dear diary, your emotions and then your name. In question number 12, you also have one more option. The director of school education, Telangana, is organizing an essay contest for all the students of the state on the topic women empowerment. Make a poster on behalf of the director of school education, Telangana. So here you have to make a poster on women empowerment. So what all you have to include? Date, time, venue, age group, number of words per essay, last date for registration and cash prize, etc. So this is the poster I will make. I know that poster should always be in a box, okay? And then you can have symbols in it or you can have some pictures in it, okay? So that you'll get prizes. So here you have essay writing competition on women empowerment. You should include date, age, time, number of words per essay, venue. So date here is 11 April 2021. Age group is, for example, the essay is for 14 to 16 years. Number of words per essay are 250 to 350. And venue will be Gandhi Memorial High School, Shivaji Nagar, Kurnool. What are the cash prizes? First prize, Rs. 50,000. Second prize, Rs. 25,000. Third prize, Rs. 15,000. And then 20 consolation prizes of Rs. 1,000, and COVID precautions should also be taken before entering the venue. And you also have to write the organizer's name here. Director of Education is organizing. So you should also write one more thing. Organized by, in this box only, Director of School Education, Telangana. That is must to write, because how will the people know who is organizing? Okay, so these are the contents which should be included in the poster. And always remember, poster should be attractive and short. Thank you very much for watching. If you understand this video, please share this video with others and also subscribe to our channel.